If you laugh at the idea of a self-help book, then you're actually on the road to self-help without even knowing it. The end of the year is always a good time for reflection and setting new goals. We're joined now by Orange County resident and the author of the book/workbook, The Art of Achievement, John O'Keefe. Nice having you with us.
Thank you for having me, Ed.
Why did you write this book?
Well, Ed, you know, I've always been fascinated by the question, why are there people of great achievement and why are there people laying in the streets? What's the difference? So, you know, years ago, my father took me down to Newport Beach and then to Beverly Hills and showed me the homes, the lifestyles, and said, this is what happens to you when you focus on community and education and work. Took me to Skid Row and said, this is what happens when you don't.
Now, you came up with some interesting characteristics, and you went to some of the movers and shakers in this world of ours. Mm-hmm. How did you decide on which movers and shakers you're going to talk to, and what did you learn?
Well, we reviewed movers and shakers over the last couple of hundred years, everything from Bill Gates to Leonardo da Vinci. And the interesting thing we found is that they all share 10 specific characteristics, each and every one. So in the book, we wrote them down, and we found that that wasn't enough. So we teach you how to implement them into your daily life as a habit through the subconscious to create daily success.
How do you do that?
Well, you focus on the specific situations that you want to do. In other words, if it's persistence that you want to key in on. And you read the passage in the book every day for 30 days. It takes 21 to 30 days for the subconscious to create a conscious habit.
How does that seem to work? Now, I know when I was state president of the California JCs in 1973 and 74, one thing that we talked about is that very thing. You need to go over it over and over again, but we came up with only 21 days. So how does it work in those particular amounts from 21 to 30 days?
Well, basically, you take a specific thought in this case, and then you focus on it. When you do that, if you were hooked up to an EEG, you'd find yourself in an alpha relaxation mode. That's where the subconscious is open to change. And you focus on specific things that you want to change through visualization, guided imagery, visualization. We talk about how to do that in the book. The important thing is the subconscious does not think emotionally, it thinks factually. So it's very important to focus on what you want in life. It's the natural law of attraction. Because what happens there is that's what you tend to attract. If we're thinking negatively in terms of, I can't do good in business, I can't do good in my life, then that's where the subconscious tends to focus and we achieve that. So it's very important to focus on the positive side of things.
You also talk a lot about laughter in this book. How does laughter then, incorporating that into your lifestyle, then equal achievement?
Well, that's a great question. And the eminent professor from Harvard, Dr. Herbert Benson, did some research and found that when we have our thought processes, both good and bad, we elicit certain specific chemical footprints. And laughter brings about all the serotonins and all the good chemicals, let's say. And that's why it's so, so important. And there's a lot of work that's been done by various physicians and institutions in finding work with cancer patients and others that have turned that around.
And it works. I've seen it happen to many people, that people that were going to have a really rough time, and it came much easier because of that laughter. Many people just don't know how to face their fears. What do you recommend in your book?
Well, you know, there's an old saying, the only way out is through. So the idea, there's two things, is verbalize your fear, what's going on, and then you can journal right through it. And then realize that the fear is a perception, and oftentimes the fear is someone else's perception that we've taken on to ourselves. It's called prestige suggestion. So take some time and understand and ask the question, is this really my fear, or am I fearing something that happened in the past due to someone that's close to me, a parent or someone who had that idea? And oftentimes we find that, for example, the people that face their fears, they find that the worst didn't happen. Often the best happened, and often a whole new opportunity opened up to them.
Now, the book itself, we got a picture of it. I assume people have already seen it. I'm not watching the monitors as we go through on this thing. But we talked about the different characteristics. Which characteristic really stands out other than laughter?
Well, there was actually three, and we found that people that had a sense of purpose, a passionate purpose, and faced their fears were the key situations. For example, the Wright brothers. Mm-hmm. The horse was the top technology at the time. And when they brought their technology on for the plane, people couldn't understand that. In fact, the plane almost didn't get made because they thought they were crazy. You can almost hear them now. You can hear, now listen to me, Orville, you're going to tell me you're going to put a person in the air in that contraption, you're going to fly them around, and then someday we're going to all go across the country in these things? You've been hitting a whiskey? You know, he had the strength of courage to continue on. He didn't let that focus and the plane was created.
Yeah.
Again, the book is very interesting. It's available from, I'm assuming, all the regular places.
Right now, my website, www.nostressforyou.com, is the easiest place to get that.
Very good.
No, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks
a lot. Thanks so much.
All right. Talk about a major...